Philippe de Bourbon, Duc d'Anjou, was born in Versailles as the second son of Louis, le Grand Dauphin of France, and Maria Anna Victoria of Bavaria. He was the younger brother of Louis, Duke of Burgundy, and was the grandson of the French King Louis XIV and Maria Theresa of Spain, who was born in Fanta of Spain. Philippe grew up in Versailles. As Philippe was not the firstborn son of the Grand Dauphin, his chances of inheriting the throne of France seemed slim. Philippe's paternal grandmother, Maria Theresa, who was the daughter of Philippe IV, had renounced her rights to the Spanish throne to be able to marry the King of France. In fact, Louis XIV and the other European kings had already agreed that the heir to the throne of Spain would be Joseph Ferdinand of Bavaria in case of the death without heirs of Charles II. However, Joseph Ferdinand of Bavaria died in 1699. Charles II, who had no heirs, feared the division of his country among the royal houses of Europe and thus decided to make his great-nephew, Philippe, his heir, in the hopes that Louis XIV would avoid the division of Spain as now his own grandson was king. Shortly after, on November 1, 1700, Charles II died. The news of the death of Charles II reached Versailles on November 6. On November 16, 1700, Louis XIV announced that he accepted the will of Charles II and he proceeded to present his 17-year-old grandson to the court as the new king of Spain. Most European monarchies, with the exception of Austria, accepted Philip as king of Spain. Philip V left Versailles on December 4 and entered Spain on January 22, 1701. On November 2, 1701, Philippe married Maria Luisa Gabriella of Savoy, the daughter of Victor Amadeus II. They had four sons together. Louis I of Spain, Philippe, who died a few days after his birth, the Infante Philippe of Spain, who died at the age of 7, and Ferdinand VI of Spain. Maria Luisa Gabriella of Savoy was very loved by the Spanish people and served as regent for her husband on several occasions. Unfortunately, she contracted tuberculosis and died on February 14, 1714. Shortly after Maria Luisa's death, Philippe remarried Elisabeth Farnese, the daughter of Odoardo Farnese and Dorothea Sophie of Neuburg. The marriage took place on December 24, 1714 in Guadalajara. From their union, six children were born. Charles III of Spain, Infanta Maria Victoria of Spain, who was briefly engaged to Louis XV of France, Infante Philippe of Spain, who married Madame Première Louise Elisabeth of France, who was the daughter of Louis XV, Infanta Maria Teresa of Spain, who married Louis Ferdinand, Dauphin of France, Infante Louis of Spain, and Infanta Maria Antonia of Spain. When Philippe V rose to power, the Austrian Habsburgs refused to accept Philippe V as king. Furthermore, Louis XIV made sure that the inheritance rights to the crown of France of his second-born grandson, the new king of Spain, remained intact. Despite the fact that the possibility of Philippe inheriting the French throne was remote, since Louis XIV's son, the great Dauphin, was in excellent health and his son and Philippe's older brother, Louis, the Duke of Burgundy, was still alive, the prospect of the union of the crowns of Spain and France, piloted from the court of Versailles, was regarded as a threat for political stability in Europe. This fear triggered the War of the Spanish Succession, which lasted from 1701 to 1714. During this war, the Bourbon states France and Spain had to face a powerful coalition consisting of Austria, Great Britain, and the Netherlands. The main goal of the Austrian-British-Dutch coalition was to avoid a growing French supremacy in Europe. Great Britain proposed Spain should either be divided between the Bourbons and the Habsburg, or, as Austria saw it, Spain should fall entirely to a younger representative of the House of Habsburg. As a consequence of the War of the Spanish Succession, Philippe V renounced his rights to the French throne in 1713 And with the removal of the danger of a Bourbon dual monarchy, the Austrian Emperor's allies were now able to accept Philip as King of Spain. The Peace of Utrecht in 1714 brought another compromise. Philip was allowed to keep all of Spain and its huge colonial empire, but he had to give up all previous possessions of Spain and Italy and the Netherlands to his opponents. Under the influence of Philip's second wife, Elisabeth Farnese, and Italian-born chief minister, Cardinal Julio Alberoni, Philip unsuccessfully set out in 1718 to regain the territorial losses from the Treaty of the Peace of Utrecht. As Philip grew older, he was increasingly troubled by depression. Because his mental state of mind impaired his ability to govern, he abdicated in 1724 in favor of his eldest son, Louis I. However, Louis died that same year, and Philip's other sons were too young to reign. So Philip V ascended again, presumably at the insistence of Elisabeth Farnese, who did not want to lose her prominent position at court. Thus, from 1724 until his death in 1746, Philip became King of Spain a second time. With time, Philip grew ever more depressed and eventually fell victim to a deep melancholia. Philip V died on July 9, 1746, and contrary to the Spanish tradition where monarchs were buried in Escorial Palace, Philip was buried in his San Ildefonso Palace. Thank you for watching this week's video. Next Saturday, we'll talk about Maria de' Medici, the mother of Louis XIII and grandmother of Louis XIV. Don't miss it! See you next week!